Hello friends, welcome to YouTube channel Cricket Online. So this is video 1.2 of sterilization. In this video I will deal with important concepts related to Z value, F naught value and many other things. So let's begin. This is about me and we will start with what is the time for sterilization. Okay, so the minimum time required for this, when you will call the sterilization process has been done, so the minimum reduction of spores would be 10 to power 12. What this indicates means your final value of n should be equal to initial value divided by 10 to the power 12. So this is known as the sterilization. So how much time it is required in order to get your final number equal to initial by this. So if you will put in this equation, what will happen? N naught by n, how much it will come? Ln 10 to power 12 equal to k into t. Further, if you will write, then 12 equal to kt. And now k, what you can write? K you can write 2.303 divided by d into t, and here it was ln 10 to power 12. So in order to convert into log 10, you have to multiply it by 2.3, and log 10 to the 10 to power 12, this will become 12 only. So 2.3 to 2.3, it will be cancelled, and what will be equal to t equal to 12 into d. Okay, so that's why it is known as the 12d concept, which is required for time of sterilization. So what is this d? D is the decimal reduction time. Okay, and this 12, if you will directly multiply, so in one mark question they can directly give, if the decimal reduction time is this much, then what is the time for sterilization? So time for sterilization equal to 12 times time for decimal reduction. Okay, so this concept and this concept you need to remember, and this is how this derivation will take place. So now this is one important concept of Z value. So I will recommend you to please remember this formula, which is log. See, in video 1.1 I told you that this d you can write as dt. Why? Because this reduction time or thermal reduction time is dependent on temperature. Its name itself is thermal. So decimal reduction time at particular temperature, suppose T1 or T2, and what is the relationship between two decimal reduction time at different temperature. So this is a temperature T1 and this is a temperature T2. So the value of T1 is standard, which is 121.1 degree centigrade or 250 degree Fahrenheit. Okay, so this is standard temperature where all thermal process takes place. In F0 value, which I will discuss in further slide, this F naught value will also with respect to 250 degrees Celsius. Okay, so let's understand what is this Z value. See, what I told, this T1 is fixed. This is 250 degree Fahrenheit. Okay, so with respect to 250 degree Fahrenheit, you will be having some decimal reduction time. Okay, so suppose any time, that is T1. So now what is this Z? This Z is nothing but T1 minus T2 is equal to Z. This Z shows the decimal reduction time of 10:1. Okay, so if Z value is given, then this T1 minus T2 is Z. So based on that you can calculate the other temperature, because this T1 is standard 250. Now for any temperature if you know, but even if you know the decimal reduction time, then what will be the decimal reduction time for this T2? This Z value itself indicated work ratio 10. So this time will be how much? 10 times of this, because this temperature is less, so decimal reduction time is higher at higher temperature. So at D2, this decimal reduction time will be 10 times of T1, or it can be asked other way around. If they will give you the T2 temperature and Z value, so you have to calculate T1, and any one decimal reduction time will be there. From there you have to calculate the again Z T2. So now if you know the T1 temperature, T2 temperature here, and by Z value, so if you are using this equation, then any one value will be not known. So any Z T1 they will give, this Z value they will give, okay, and any one temperature. So with respect to all this equation, you have to calculate the other Z T2. So I will show you one numerical based on this, so this equation will be more clear. So for now you understand what is the significance of Z. So what is unit of Z? Z is in degree Celsius or degree Fahrenheit. So this temperature difference shows a 10^1 of decimal reduction time. Okay. So the term Z represents temperature range degree Fahrenheit for 10^1 decimal reduction time. So now if you will solve this equation, you will take common this log and you will transfer this log to the right hand side, then you will know this particular equation. That is also to calculate the any one unknown parameter. So the purpose of these two equations is same only. You can remember any one equation so that missing parameter can be calculated. So I hope what is Z value and what is the significance of this you are able to understand. So now moving towards other concept, that is the F0 value. So in last video I showed you these two equations. So here T equal to D log 10 N by N0. So here this T is time, D is decimal reduction time. You can write this at DT because it is on temperature. So now if this time and this temperature, for if you are taking this time as F0 and this temperature is 250, then this equation will become nothing but this equation. Okay, and what is this F0? This F0 is time, and remember in minute, at what? At this standard temperature, that is 250 degree Fahrenheit or 121.1 degree Celsius. Okay, so that will produce the same degree of sterilization as given process at its temperature T. So what it says, suppose you have any temperature T that is 350 degree Fahrenheit. Okay, it is this temperature is creating some degree of sterilization, means some value of N with respect to N0 divided by something, suppose X. Okay, so and it will be doing it in certain time, suppose D. So what will be the value at 250 degree? So that value will known as F0 value. Okay, for same degree of sterilization. So this is the common parameter. Okay, so this F0 is nothing but it is the time. So that will create the same degree of sterilization at 250 degree Celsius. Okay, so this is the meaning of this statement. Any temperature, its sterilization effect at time T or D, then what will be the time taken to do the same process at 250 degree Fahrenheit? Why we are taking 250? Because this is the standard time for this sterilization process. That's why we take at 250. So now if you will use these two equations, so you replace this D250 by DT, and this DT is also same DT. So you will get one final equation, that is F naught equal to T 10 to the power TF minus 250. So this F naught, this is time with respect to 250, and this T is time with respect to this T. So this will be creating some degree of sterilization. So if they will ask what will be the time taken at some other temperature, that is T, so what time you will calculate, that will be equal to this time. Okay, so F naught value is suppose 10 minutes. So if F naught value has been given directly, you will know temperature is 250. If Z value is this one, then what is the time taken and what will be the time required at 350 degree Fahrenheit. So you need to simply use this equation. Okay, so because of this, I would recommend to remember this equation also. So such type of question directly you can solve. So this is all about this video. In next video, I will take the past year numerical problem. So what you got from this video, you got what is the Z value and what is the F naught value and what is their significance and what is their meaning. So these two is very confusing concept. If you do watch this video one or two times, then you will get more clarity. So thank you for watching this video.